A year ago, we were all sitting together, next to each other, no masks. So in the past year, we've had to pivot. How do we teach students to broadcast the weather on a green screen when we can't be all together to stand on a green screen? I always told students, if you don't have an internship, you won't have a resume reel, and then you don't have anything to show to get a job. Texas A&M is here, and it has the tools to be able to still make those resume reels. There's a green screen on the 12th floor of the O&M. The room is small, but with social distancing and small enough groups, we can get in there, we can still get them to the technology.
Shell has been super great, and I started expressing to him that there was interest at A&M to build a TV broadcasting program. And I mean, instantly, like the first thing, he's like, let me know how I can help. It is completely student-led, and what we do is we have groups of 3 students a night, 5 nights a week, who come and produce their own weather forecast that is then on air, and it is also on all of our social media platforms.
Jeanette, without even graduating yet, has become a rock star in the meteorology world. There's something called the AMS, the American Meteorological Society, and she has jumped fully into that. And Jeanette has ingrained herself in a group that is working to not only communicate weather in English, but also in Spanish, which is very important because that's a community that historically has been underserved with weather information. And we're trying to standardize that language. So when a severe thunderstorm warning comes out, there's something that also comes out at the same time in Spanish.
Tenemos estas tormentas que pasaron.
Spanish is my first language. My parents immigrated from Mexico. I've become really passionate over time of just communicating the weather in Spanish, especially in places like here in the Bryan College Station area. What I've been trying to do is I've been trying to just kind of teach myself all weather terminology in Spanish, which has been a challenge even with Spanish being my first language. If I've learned anything from my time here at A&M, it's how important selfless service is. And so the fact that I'm bilingual, I feel like that's one way that I can serve a community in need. And to be able to do that in Spanish to people who I relate to because of my Hispanic background. This program has helped me tremendously.